to the cohort of 2018. "Sometimes," said Pooh, "the smallest things take up the most room in your heart. I think we can all take some advice from Winnie the Pooh. He has some very profound things to say."
"How do you spell love?" said Piglet. "You don't spell it, you feel it," said Pooh.
To non-members of the Carey community, the name Carey may just forever be another school. But to myself, my cohort, and the thousands of students that have had the privilege to attend this school, that name holds significant weight.
When Pooh saw Christopher Robin trying to pull on his gumboots in preparation for an expedition to find the North Pole, he said, "As soon as I saw you, I knew a grand adventure was about to begin." The North Pole was found in the form of a stick, but to Pooh, it was more about the people and the friends.
Friendships often also start small, and as they develop, they are the relationships that become most important to us. At Carey, friendships are formed in all different ways, and most of them start small.
Middle school and senior school were full of opportunities, richness, and more shared experiences. Music and rowing have been two of my most significant adventures. I could tell you exactly who was in every single crew I've ever coxed, those who shared the disappointments and the celebrations, and those who provided motivation and laughs. The shared experiences have defined the adventures and were what made it all possible and memorable.
Recollecting memories of Year 9, everyone can relate to that daunting feeling of walking into a classroom filled with people you don't really know.
From these small encounters, really amazing friendships can grow.
To the cohort of 2018, as my best mate Winnie the Pooh once said, when you see someone putting on their big boots, you can be pretty sure that an adventure is going to happen.
Metaphorically speaking,
we are continually learning how to put on our big boots, to acknowledge a setback, to recognise a challenge, and to relish our steps forward.
15 years ago, at the brink of my life at Carey, I would never have imagined to be in the position that I am in today, with the friendships and the understanding that I now possess.
Friendship has been one of the best, if not the best aspects of Carey, which has accompanied you in your journey from prep to now.
Through this journey, I have also begun to understand how meaningful relationships and experiences often take time to be formed. Like Winnie the Pooh says, if the person you are talking to doesn't appear to be listening, be patient. It may simply be that he has a small piece of fluff in his ear.
But what about the moments when some friends were away sick, on holiday or in camp? That unique sense of joy that you experienced with that friend was not there.
This void that was felt reminds me of a Winnie the Pooh quote, "I wonder what Piglet is doing," said Pooh. "I wish I was there doing it too."
Dear class of 2018, if everything is honey and I am what I eat, I must be made of honey and life is pretty sweet, by Pooh.
Most of our sweetest memories are with our favourite people, our friends. And every moment we spend with these special people, each memory that we take contributes to who we are today.
By seeing things the way Pooh does and taking our friendships as our life's food, it is easy to see that life really is pretty sweet.
How lucky am I to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard. As we reach the end of our 18-year journey, it has been and will continue to be incredibly difficult to say goodbye. What is special about the friendships formed here is the common love that we all hold for our community and culture, and I think that this is something that will stay with us for the rest of our lives. I feel blessed to have been a small part of something that will be so hard to say goodbye to. If it had have been easy to leave, then it wouldn't have been worth it.
You see, honey isn't just sticky, it also never expires. And in this way, essentially what we can carry forward as we start the next part of our lives are the sweetness of friendships which never go out of date.
Dear class of 2018, as we all sit in Melbourne Town Hall for our last ever speech night, we have graduated, meaning we won't be together as a cohort from 8 to 3 on Monday to Fridays anymore. But before you let that sink in, there's one thing Carey has taught us all the same, and that's that we don't need Monday to Fridays to stay connected and in touch. Let this serve as a reminder to each graduate of 2018 that the friendships you formed from your respective time at Carey are strongly built and extremely difficult to break.
My friends at Carey are invaluable to me and are honestly what has made my school experience so amazing and what allows me to genuinely enjoy coming every day.
Like Pooh and Piglet, for times to come, the unique friendships that have been strengthened and developed at our time at Carey will continue to be shared.
Carey offers amazing opportunities and I've been encouraged to take them up, to venture beyond my comfort zone and to try hard when there's no guarantee of success. there was always support and guidance, close by in the early years and more covert in the later years.
To me, this is what Carey has been, the most incredible place to meet the most remarkable people and an environment which has enabled us to go beyond ourselves every day.
I regularly enjoy looking back on my journey, from the timid, quirky girl in Year 7 to the happy, confident, yet still quirky girl who's developed countless friendships within the Carey community.
Throughout my Carey journey, noticing the goodness has allowed me to maximise my experiences and create memories and friendships that I am so grateful for.
Despite Carey being the space where you met most of your greatest friends, remind yourself of how our school taught us to be kind, loving, and supportive of one another. School teaches you more than just academics. When you take a step back and really think about it, the years where we mature as individuals happened at our time at Carey. So if you think you've learnt nothing about genetics or calculus, then you can at least know and see that you've learnt what it means to be a great friend to others.
As the saying goes, we are what we eat and therefore we are our life's choices. Throughout our Carey journey and in every choice, friendship and memory we've made, we can decide to look at things with a positive perspective.
Although our time together has come to an end, the friendships and memories we hold will live on forever.
I would not exchange any second of my Carey years and will be devastated to say goodbye to you all.
As sad as it is, the memories of the friendships will always be there to look back on, and I am sure they will continue to strengthen in the future.
No school is perfect, but I really believe that Carey has been perfect for me. And this is because of the friendships and relationships I have formed in my time here.
It's the people that have made the difference. The staff, the teachers, the students, family, coaches, conductors, mentors, and mostly my friends.
So what we can take looking forward is to see the greatness and sweetness from our time together. And in the words of William Carey himself, let's attempt great things for God and expect great things from God.
There is a difference between goodbye and letting go, and I think that none of us will ever truly let go of the friendships and memories we have made here.
It's an intimidating time in our lives, but from me to each and every single graduate of 2018 at Carey Baptist Grammar School, promise me you'll always remember you're braver than you believe and stronger than you seem and smarter than you think. Let Christopher Robbins' words be a final takeaway before you all venture out into the world and do amazing things, perhaps things involving your best pals.
Love always, Claire.
From Felicity.
From Sarah.
From Riley.
From Lachlan.
From Pat.
From Joey.
Sincerely, Cara.
Love always, Grace.
I know.